Dear students, welcome back to a new mathematics session. In today's session, we shall discuss a new chapter, that is chapter number 6 from the NCERT textbook, that is linear inequalities. Let's move on to the topic. Before discussing about linear inequalities, let's recall the concept of linear equation. Consider an example, x is equal to 2. Here when we consider this equation, here there is an equal to symbol, so that is called equation. And here it is one variable because there is only one alphabet, that is x. So x is equal to 2, it is in one variable equation. And the next one, if we consider 2x plus 3y is equal to 12. Here also you can see x is one alphabet and y is another alphabet. So x and y, two alphabets are there, that's why it is called two variables. And it contains an equal to symbol, that is why it is an equation. So that is the first condition which we need to satisfy, that is order of the variable must be equal to 1. For a linear equation, order of the variable should be 1. So order means you can see the highest power. So when you check x here, the highest power is 1. And here x when we consider, the power is 1. And y when we consider, that is also power having 1. So the order of the variable should be 1. And gives a straight line on the graph. When we draw the graph of these equations, we should get a straight line. So let's check. For making this graph, it is easy. Directly we can draw it, but here we need to get a set of values. See, for example, when we put x is equal to 0 in this equation, x is equal to 0, when we put it in the equation, 2 into 0, that is 0. So 0 plus 3y is equal to 12. 0 plus 3y is equal to 12. And from here, when we calculate the value of y will be 12 by 3. Y is equal to 12 by 3, that is equal to 4. So this is what the first value we have got. Next, when we put x is equal to 6, x is equal to 6, when we put 2 into 6, 2 into 6 is 12. So 12 plus 3y is equal to 12. 12 plus 3y equal to 12. And here when we check, both right side and left side is having 12, so we can cancel it, 12 and 12. So 3y is equal to 0, and from here y we will get, y is equal to 0 by 3. 0 by 3 is 0. So that is the second value we have got here. Then by using these points, we have to plot it in a graph sheet. So first of all, let's take a graph sheet and draw the axis, x-axis and y-axis, and plot the point as we need. So 1 to 7 x-axis and 1 to 8 on the y-axis. And first, x is equal to 2. When we consider x is equal to 2, this is order having 1 and it is having only one variable. And let's check whether it is a straight line or not when we draw it in the graph sheet. Clearly, x is equal to 2, the point is here. When we draw a line, it is a line parallel to y-axis will be coming. So clearly this is a straight line. So both the conditions are satisfied. First condition is what? Order of the variable is 1. Highest degree if you check, it is 1. Then straight line on the graph. Give straight line on the graph. Clearly it is a straight line. Now let's plot this point 0, 4. 0, 4 means it will be coming here. And next is 0, 6. 0, 6 is coming. Sorry, 6, 0. It is coming here. When we join these two points, we will be getting again a straight line. So this is the graph of x plus 2x plus 3y is equal to 12. So let's recall about the linear equation. If linear equation means it should have order of the variable 1, and when we plot that equation in the graph sheet, we should get a straight line. Next, we shall discuss about inequalities. Mainly there are four inequality symbols. The first one is less than, second one is less than or equal to, third one is greater than, and next one is greater than or equal to. So these four symbols are called inequality symbols. And consider an example, that is x less than or equal to 2. This is an inequality, linear inequality we can say, because when we have learned about linear equations in the previous slide, for example, x is equal to 2 we have considered there. Here the highest power is 1, and again when we draw this one in a graph sheet, we will get a straight line. And here also the same condition is satisfied. The highest power is 1 and it is in one variable, and this is called a linear inequality. Inequality means this, any one of these four symbols are included, then we can say that it is an inequality. Instead of less than or equal to, if there is equal to symbol, then we can say it is an equation. Another example, if you consider 2x plus 3y greater than 12, this is also an example of linear inequality. And there are two variables, one is x and another one is y, and it is an inequality because it contains a greater symbol. Greater symbol is one of the inequality symbols. So this is what we have learned, this is what we are going to discuss in this chapter, that is about linear inequalities. So here definition says two real numbers or two algebraic expressions related by the symbols less than or equal to, greater than or equal to form an inequality. Two real numbers means, of course, instead of a variable there is a chance of coming numbers, constants also. See, for example, 1 is less than 2. 1 is less than 2 is also an inequality. And here all the algebraic expressions, algebraic expression means, of course, it contains a variable, x less than or equal to 2, 2x plus 3y greater than 2, related by the symbols less than, because these left hand side and right hand side are related by using these four, any one of these four symbols, either less than or equal to, greater or greater than or equal to, form an inequality. This is the definition of inequality. Next, we shall discuss the exercise problems. Exercise 6.1. First question, solve 24x less than 100 when, first one, x is a real number. So we all know how to solve equations. So here, while solving inequality also, more or less the same pattern only we have to follow. Only some little changes are there that will be discussed. Here, 24x less than 100. This is called an inequality because it contains an inequality symbol, that is less than. So let's write that inequality, 24x less than 100. So in case of an equation, what we do? To find out the value of x, we bring 24 to the right side, that comes as a denominator. The same thing only here also, that is x less than 100 by 24. So 100 by 24, when we divide, x less than 4.16 will be coming. You can try it in the rough work or just to do it on the right side of your notebook. So when we divide 100 with 24, we'll be getting 4.16. Now, x is less than 4.16 means any number which is less than 4.16 can be the value of x. So here, x, what is x? X is a natural number. We know that natural numbers means it is a set of values, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. This is called natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, etc. So 1, 2, 3, etc. are natural numbers. And here, the value of x is less than 4.16. Less than 4.1 means up to 4. So here you can see natural numbers means 1, 2, 3, no decimal numbers will be coming. So 4.16 means just the previous value of 4.16 natural number is 4. So the numbers up to 4, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, these are natural numbers. From here, we can take up to 4, that is 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is the solution. And the next one is x is an integer. So as we know, integer means it is etc, minus 1, 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc will be coming. Then from there, we will be taking this condition, x less than 4.16. Once again, I will write the integer values, that is etc will be coming. Then there will be negative value, that is minus 3, then minus 2. Then we will be having minus 1, then we will be having 0, then we will be having 1, and it goes etc up to infinity. Then here the condition is what? X less than 4.16 means x is smaller than 4.16 means 4 will be somewhere here. So up to 4, the left side all will be coming. The negative values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to here is less than 4.16. So x is an integer means it takes the values etc, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 4. Okay, 5 will not come because the value of x is just less than 4.16, smaller than 4.16. Next, we shall discuss the second question. Solve minus 12x greater than 30 when x is a natural number. Here, when we check the inequality, there is a negative sign along with x. So the coefficient of x is minus 12. This is the only case we need to take care while solving the linear inequality. The rest all same like equations we can solve. But when x is having a negative sign, there is a condition which we need to apply. That is the only one condition we need to study in linear inequalities, solving linear inequalities. So let's write the inequality, minus 12x greater than 30. So since the coefficient of x is negative, this is the condition. Since x is negative, we multiply both sides by minus 1. Both the sides minus 1 we have to multiply. What will happen here if you multiply minus 1? It becomes plus 12. And here if you multiply minus 1, it becomes minus 30. Then what will happen? Change the signs. Change the sign means this inequality symbol will change. That means this is greater symbol at present, and it will change to less than. So it comes as x less than, as I said before, the sign changed to this is plus and this is minus because we have multiplied minus 1. Now what happened here is this becomes minus 30 and this 12 will come to the denominator. Same time this inequality symbol will change, greater will change to less. Okay, this is the condition we need to take care. Then 30 by 12 when we divide, it will be getting minus 2.5. So x less than minus 2.5. So here x is a natural number, so we need to find out the possible solution. Since x is a natural number, there is no natural number less than minus 2.5 because the natural number set is starting from 1 to 3. Okay, starting from 1 and it goes up to infinity, all positive numbers. And we have got the value of x as less than minus 2.5, smaller than a negative number. It is not possible because natural number is having only positive numbers. So there is no natural number less than minus 2.5. This is our answer. The second one is x is an integer. We know that integer number means x starting from etc. and minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. it goes. And here x less than minus 2.5. x less than minus 2.5 means here minus 2 is there, minus 2.5 will be here, just behind this minus 2. Okay, so it comes as just previous value of minus 2 is here comes as a minus 3. This here comes as a minus 3. So minus 2.5 comes between minus 2 and minus 3. Between minus 2 and minus 3 only minus 2.5 comes. So x less than minus 2.5 means up to minus 3 from etc. it will be ending up to minus 3. That means etc. means of course we can start from minus 6, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3, up to minus 3. This is the last value. Next one, if you take, it comes as minus 2. Minus 2 is greater than this minus 2.5. So the solution is etc. minus 6, minus 5, minus 4, minus 3. Next we shall discuss the third question. Solve 5x minus 3 less than 7. When x is an integer. So here x is an integer, that is the first condition. So here when we check the value of or the coefficient of x, it is a positive value only, so nothing to care, no need to take extra care and all. We can just proceed as usual. Let's write the inequality 5x minus 3 less than 7. Then 5x is less than this minus 3 comes to the right side, it comes as 7 plus 3. 5x less than 10, then x less than 10 by 5, then x less than 2. Here 5 into x, this 5 coming to the right side, it comes as divided by 5. So x less than 10 by 5, 10 by 5 is 2, x less than 2 will become. Now x less than 2, what is x? X is an integer. Integer means we know negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers. So here up to 2 only will become, less than 2. Less than 2 means up to 1. So negative numbers, 0 and 1 will be coming. That is etc. minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, all negative numbers included, then 0 and 1. 2 will not come here because here there is no equal to symbol. Less than or equal to 2 means 2 will be coming. Here only less than 2 means smaller than 2, up to 1 only will be coming. Next is x is a real number. Real number means set of numbers will be there, like decimal numbers, positive numbers, negative numbers, means integers, decimal number, all will be included there. That means x is a real number which is less than 2. Less than 2 means from where it will start? It starts from minus infinity. Just starts from minus infinity up to 2. Okay. Thus x element of minus infinity to 2. This is open interval. This is not a closed interval. Closed interval means this is called the closed interval. So just like square brackets. This is called closed interval because closed interval means what we will do is both the first value and second value is included. But here less than 2 means up to 2 only, just too close to 2 only, but 2 will not take. So here 2 will be coming, but it is an open interval. Open interval, if you show, 2 is not there, but just too close to 2, up to just near to 2, to that value we will take. Okay, so this is the solution, x element of minus infinity comma 2. All the decimal numbers also included there. So means rational numbers also included there, because of that only we are taking from minus infinity to 2. But here x is an integer. Integer means negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers only. So all these round figures only will be taken. But when we are taking a real numbers, we take from minus infinity to 2, open interval, both all the numbers. Next, we shall discuss question number 4. Solve 3x plus 8 greater than 2 when x is an integer. So let's start solving. First, write the inequality 3x plus 8 greater than 0, then 3x. Here, the coefficient of x is positive, so nothing to care. Just to proceed as usual. Take plus 8 to the right side, it comes as minus 8. That means 3x greater than minus 6. Here also the coefficient of x is negative, positive only. Okay, so no need to bother. Then x greater than minus 6 divided by 3. Of course, here right side minus 6 is there, but no need to change any inequality symbol and all. Just as usual, we can proceed. So x greater than minus 6 by 3. That is x greater than minus 2. Here x is an integer. So integer means negative numbers, 0 and positive numbers. So x greater than minus 2. Greater than minus 2 means from where minus 1 onwards, it will start to minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Next is x is a real number. X is a real number means we know that it includes all rational and irrational numbers. Means decimal numbers also will be coming there. So since x is a real number which is greater than minus 2, that means x element of greater than minus 2 means starting from a number which is very close to minus 2. That means open interval minus 2 to till infinity. Just both are open interval, open brackets you have to write. Minus 2, comma infinity. Next we shall discuss question number 5. Solve the given inequality for real x, 4x plus 3 less than 5x plus 7. So here, just write the inequality, then bring the like terms one side, means variables one side, constant another side. That is 4x minus 5x is less than 7. This plus 3 comes to the right side, it is minus 3. Then 4x minus 5x. 4x minus 5x is minus x. Minus x is less than 7 minus 3 is 4. So minus x less than 4. Minus x less than 4 means you see the variable x is having a negative sign. So what we have to do? We have to recall the law. That is, x is negative means we multiply minus 1 on both sides. Means sign will change. This minus becomes plus x. This becomes minus 4. Then same time we have to change the inequality symbol. That means less becomes greater. So x greater than minus 4 will be coming. So here all real value of x, that means real number system. Up to real number system condition is what? Greater than minus 4. Means we will start from minus 4 to infinity. That means open interval minus 4 comma infinity. Next one, question number 6. Solve the given inequality 3x minus 7 greater than 5x minus 1. Write the inequality, then arrange, means bring the variables one side, constant another side. So 3x, this 5x comes to the left side, that is minus 5x. So 3x minus 5x, that is minus 2x. Okay, we will write it, that one, that will be fine. That is 3x. 3x minus 5x. 3x minus 5x is minus 2x. That is what it is written here, minus 2x. Then on the right side, if you check, that is minus 1 plus 7. Minus 1 plus 7 is 6. That is what it is written on the right hand side. Then from here x we can calculate. That means this 2 we are bringing to the right side. That means division will be coming, 6 divided by 2. Left side is minus x. So minus x is greater than 6 by 2. That means minus x is greater than 3 will be coming. 6 by 2 is 3. Now what is the problem? Here the variable is having a negative sign. So coefficient of x is having minus 1. So what we have to do? We have to multiply minus 1. That means we have to change the sign. Minus becomes plus, and here also right side plus becomes minus. So x is on the left side, on right side it is 3, sorry, minus 3. Then what do you have to do again? Change the sign. Change the sign means this greater becomes less. So x less than minus 3. Once again we have to multiply minus on both sides. That means this minus is gone, it becomes plus x, and 6 by 2, that is 3, 3 becomes minus 3 will be coming. Same time change the inequality symbol, greater becomes less. So x less than minus 3. So it is a real number system. X less than minus 3 means the solution is minus infinity to up to minus 3. Up to minus 3, but it is open interval. Okay, minus infinity to minus 3, because it is less than minus 3. Next we shall discuss question number 7. Solve the given inequality for real x, 3 into x minus 1 less than or equal to 2 into x minus 3. So little more complicated question. Just what we have to do is remove the bracket. That is 3 into x is 3x, minus 3 into 1 is 3, less than or equal to 2 into x is 2x, minus 3 into 2 is 6. As before, bring the variables one side, this 2x comes to the left side, it comes as minus 2x. This minus 3 comes to the right side, it comes as plus 3 minus 6 plus 3. Then 3x minus 2x is x less than or equal to minus 6 plus 3 is minus 3. So x less than or equal to minus 3. Since x is a real number, what we can do is less than or equal to minus 3. Here equal to symbol is there, less than or equal to minus 3. So the solution is, open bracket will start, less than means it comes from infinity, minus infinity to minus 3, and it is a closed bracket here, sorry, it is a square bracket here, closed interval. So here it is open interval because we are just taking up to infinity, and on the other hand, it is up to minus 3. Minus 3 means it is included. Why it is included? Because it is less than or equal to, up to minus 3 will be taking. For showing that, we will use a square bracket on the right side. Here, left side is, it is open bracket. Okay. Then, question number 8. Solve the given inequality for real x. 3 into 2 minus x is greater than or equal to 2 into 1 minus x. As before, write the inequality, then remove the bracket. 3 into 2 is 6, minus 3 into x, greater than or equal to 2 into 1 is 2, minus 2 into x is 2x. So here, 6 minus 3x, this minus 2x bring to the left side, it comes as plus 3x is greater than or equal to 2. Then here, minus 3x plus 2x, that is minus x is greater than or equal to 6, bring to the right side, it comes as 2 minus 6. All the arrangement you can do in one step, it is not a problem. Here, two steps I have written. So if you want to do it, everything here, just to proceed as before what we have done here, okay? Then, minus x is greater than or equal to 2 minus 6. We know that x is negative, so we multiply both sides by minus 1. So here, minus, if you multiply minus 1, this becomes plus x. 2 minus x is minus 4. And that will be coming like this, that is minus x greater than minus 4 will be coming. When we multiply both sides, negative signs, what will happen? This becomes x. And on the other hand, right side becomes 4, and thus inequality will change, that is less than. So that is x less than or equal to 4. Of course, here equal to symbol is there. I didn't put that one, that also you have to put, okay? Less than or equal to. Okay. So x less than or equal to 4. Here also real number system only. So the solution comes from minus infinity to 4, but 4 is included. So here it should be square bracket because there is an equal to symbol. Less than or equal to 4, smaller than or equal to 4, that means starting from infinity to 4, and 4 is included, means on the right hand side, right part you will put a square bracket, and on the left part you will put a open bracket. Next we shall discuss the 9th question. Solve the given inequality for real x. X plus x by 2 plus x by 3 less than 11. Let's write the inequality. Then you can see here x is there on the left hand side common. Let's take out x. When we take common, first there will be 1 balance plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 3 less than 11. Then what we can do here, we can do little bit of calculation in the bracket. We can take the LCM 6, 2 and 3 LCM is 6. So here there is no denominator, so we have to multiply that 2 and 3. So 2 into 3 plus, here the denominator is 2, that means we have to multiply 1 with 3, 1 into 3 is 3. Then here denominator is 3, that means we have to multiply 2. So 1 into 2 is 2 divided by 6 less than 11. Next is x into 2 into 3 is 6, 6 plus 3 9 plus 2 11, 11 by 6 less than 11. So here when we check this left hand side, there is 1 11 is there, right hand side also there is 1 11, cancel, then we will be having 1. Then when we cross multiply it, this 6 will be coming here, 6 will be coming here. So x less than 6 will be coming. X is less than 6, so the solution will be from minus infinity to 6, but here there is no equal to symbol, that means there is no square bracket, all open bracket only. So open bracket, minus infinity comma 6 is the solution. The 10th question, solve the given inequality for real x, x by 3 greater than x by 2 plus 1. So this question we will try it as homework. Dear students, today we have started a new chapter, that is linear inequalities, and we have solved first 10 questions from exercise 6.1. Go through the exercise questions and solve it independently in a sheet of paper. While solving, if you have any doubt, please mark it and keep. We will discuss it during the discussion session. Thank you for watching.